What was that? That sound. It sounds like an animal growling. Oh, it's coming closer. Stay back. I'll use my slipper on you. Stay back. I'm going to switch the lights on. Oh, goodness, you've got to be kidding me. It's my teddy bear, my tiger teddy bear. Well, I'm glad that it's only my tiger teddy bear, not a real tiger. Phew, I feel so much better. Hey kids, welcome to Kids Church Online. Have you ever felt scared when in the dark you hear a scary sound and it's coming closer and you think, oh no, something is going to get you? I know I have. Sure, and I'm glad it was only my teddy bear tiger. So, kids, today we'll be focusing on how to overcome our fears by replacing our fear with faith in God. So, we'll be crossing over to our Mythbuster Kiana, who will bust the lies of our fears so we can put our faith and our trust in our God. So, enjoy, kids.
Hello, my little Mythbusters. So, if you didn't know what a Mythbuster is, that is someone that takes a lie and sees if it is true or not. So, Detective Casey told us that we are going to be taking on fear. So, what is fear? Fear is something that you are scared of. Fear gains its power by making us imagine something that might happen rather than making us imagine something that is happening. Let me set the scene for you. You and your mom and dad go walking in the morning. It's bright, it's beautiful, you can see everything around you. Or you go walk in the evening. You can't really see anything, so you start to think there might be something behind the bush, or there might be something behind the tree that's just waiting to come out and jump at you. Fear gains its control by going into our imagination and saying this little lie telling you that you are not safe. If you start to imagine that fear, you are convincing yourself that it will happen in the darkness. Sometimes the things that we fear are small or little or silly, but most of the times it can be a very big fear. So God knew that we would struggle with fear. That is why He is with us every step of the way. So if you don't know, if you fear of something, just remember God is always next to you. We are all going through something at the moment with schools closing down and jobs closing down. So we start to fear that we might not be able to go back to school. We might not be able to see our friends again, or we might not have that concert or sports day that we wished we could have. So God wants us to live in faith. He wants us to take fear and rather put faith in its place. I want to put a scripture on for you. In Isaiah 41 verse 10, it says, "Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am God." So I want to show you, but before I do, I need to put on my protective wear. So this is my protective hat that I'm going to put on, my protective goggles, and my protective jacket. This hammer is the hammer of truth, and I want to see if this hammer of truth is in a crushed faith. So let's test it out. The truth says that you should not be afraid of the unknown. The truth says that you should not be afraid of the darkness. The truth says that you must always believe in God, and then you will not be afraid. And the truth says there is no such thing as monsters under your bed or in your cupboard. Now, as we can see, this truth, this hammer of truth, crushed fear. Now, fear is out of our way, and we replace it with faith. With faith, we put our trust completely in God, and He has a plan for you. But now, I want to see if this truth can crush faith. See, it doesn't crush it. So if you replace faith in fear, you will not be afraid. Again, if you are fearful of something, remember that scripture I gave you in Isaiah 41 verse 10. Now before I close out, I want to do a prayer. So if any of you guys are feeling fearful or you have fear in your heart, I want you to stand up and pray with me. You can put your hands up or you can leave it down. Father God, I ask you to please take this fearfulness or fear that is in your child's heart. I want them to know that they have you with them every step of the way. I want them to know that they can put faith in you so you can carry them through them. Father God, I just ask for your presence to be in here today. I ask you so that they can grasp this message and let them not be afraid. Now, before we go, I want you to please put your praise shoes on and we are gonna praise God.
Staring into your eyes makes my heart come alive. I'm suddenly brought to life when I met you. Reaching beyond the skies, running deep, stretching wide. Love is for real, you will never let go, never let go. Oh, it's more than just words, love beyond my control, out of control. This is real love, this is real love. This is real love, this is real love.
This is real love.
I hope you enjoyed our lesson today about how to overcome our fears by replacing our fears with our faith and putting our trust in God, because He is good and He will protect us whenever we're feeling afraid. So you know what? I know that I'll be safe tonight. I know that I will sleep sweet, because it says in the Bible that when I rest and lay my head on my pillow tonight, my sleep will be sweet. So I know that I'll be safe tonight. So kids, remember to fix your eyes on Jesus. Keep safe and keep moving forward in all that God has for you. We'll see you again next week.